Hello guys, what up? Welcome back to my channel. So today, before we continue to talk about this high-tech utopia, and I want to share a story that's related to our topic. Okay, actually, I know a person, but here I don't want to reveal his name because that's not like appropriate. He was a teacher before, but he became rich. He became super rich overnight. What he did was he invested in some stuff. Okay. But when he became super rich, his first reaction was not, finally he was like free, right? So he could do whatever he liked to do. But instead, he became like depressed because, his motivation, his life, whether teaching or writing, not, at that time that was gone. So he lost his sense of a purpose and aim to his life. So that's what actually happened. Okay. 好了，先跟大家分享一个和题目有关的一个故事啊。OK，那么当人变得这个富有之后吧，或者是财务自由之后，那么有时候人的反应呢是比较奇怪的，是吧？希望有一天呢，我也知道这个反应是什么。OK，好，我们听一下这个第一段的录音。
Positional goods, which boost the status of their owners, are also still likely to exist and are, by their nature, scarce. Even if AIs surpass humans in art, intellect, music, and sport, humans will probably continue to derive value from surpassing their fellow humans, for example, by having tickets to the hottest events. In 1977, Fred Hirsch, an economist, argued in The Social Limits to Growth that as wealth increases, a greater fraction of human desire consists of positional goods. Time spent competing goes up, the price of such goods increases, and so their share of GDP rises. The pattern may continue in an AI utopia.
Okay. Positional goods 啊，positional position 是地啊，那个位置啊，这个地方指的是这个地位啊，能够显示地位的商品。Which boost the status of their owners, okay, 能够提升他们拥有者地位的商品，啊，boost 是提升提振，are also likely to exist and are by the nature scarce, okay, are also likely, are also still likely to exist, okay, 那么也是啊，还是呢，看起来呢，仍然会存在啊，okay, and are by their nature, 那么根据他们的特点的话呢，是稀缺的，okay, 好。那么这个地方的话呢，positional goods 啊，它的这个谓语动词在这个地方是吧？OK，是 are 什么什么啊？那么后边呢是做表语啊，OK。然后呢，这个地方 and 呢也是并列了这个 are，OK。那么这个地方呢应该是一个并列的这个谓语动词，OK。当然这个地方的话呢是一个定语从句是吧？OK。那么这个 positional goods are 什么什么 and are 什么什么，OK，是这样一个结构。Even if AIs surpass humans in art, intellect, music, and sport, humans will probably continue to derive value from surpassing their fellow humans. Okay. 尽管的话呢，尽管如果啊，那个 AIs 就是这些人工智能呢，surpass 超越了人类啊。OK，在艺术上方面，在那个智商方面啊，智能上，OK，音乐和体育都超过了。Humans will probably continue to derive value 啊，人类有可能啊，OK，有可能会继续呢获得这个价值吧，OK，有这个感觉到有价值啊，from surpassing 通过超越他们自己的这个人类啊，那么我们比 AI 比不了，那么我们比人类还比不了嘛，是吧？OK，For example, by having tickets to the hottest events，比如说呢，买票啊，拥有这个票。到最热门的一些活动啊，就好像现在这个，有人会去攀比呢，买这个演唱会的最好的座位的这个门票一样。In 1977, okay, Fred Hirsch, an economist, argued in the Social Limits to Growth that, okay, 有一个经济学家啊，他叫那个 Fred，那么他在这本书里边啊，《The Social Limits to Growth》，okay，叫社会的限制啊，社会对社会的限制啊，是那个。对于增长的限制啊，OK，对于增长的社会限制啊，这本书，as wealth increases 啊，伴随着这个财富的增加，a greater fraction of human desire consists of positional goods，OK， fraction 是部分啊，一大部分的人类的这个欲望啊，OK，包含了是那个叫地位的啊，就是显示地位的商品。Time spent competing goes up。OK，好了，那么这个时间啊，然后什么样的时间呢？是这个分词结构的修饰这个时间啊，就是 spent competing 啊，花费到竞争的这个时间。那么 time goes up，时间上升了。OK，the price of such goods increases。那么这类商品的价格呢增长。So their share of GDP rises。因此呢，他们的 GDP 的份额会上升啊。This pattern may continue in an AI utopia. OK，那么这种模式呢，在这个 AI 乌托邦时代呢，有可能也会继续。OK，好，next part，我们继续听下一部分。
Mr. Bostrom notes some types of competition are a failure of coordination. If everyone agrees to stop competing, they would have time for other better things, which could further boost growth. Yet some types of competition, such as sport, have intrinsic value and are worth preserving. Humans may also have nothing better to do. Interest in chess has grown since IBM's Deep Blue first defeated Garry Kasparov, then world champion, in 1997. An entire industry has emerged around e-sports, where computers can comfortably defeat humans. Their revenues are expected to grow at a 20% annual rate over the next decade, reaching nearly $11 billion by 2032. Several groups in society today give us a sense of how future humans might spend their time. Aristocrats and bohemians enjoy the arts. Monastics live within themselves. Athletes spend their lives on sport. The retired dabble in all these pursuits.
Okay, Mr. Bostrom notes some types of competition are a failure of coordination. Okay，好，那么这个人啊，他notes 啊，注意到啊，OK，或者是写到一些的这个竞争的话呢，是一个叫协调的这个失败啊，OK，协调的失败，failure of coordination. Okay，if everyone agreed to stop competing，如果每个人呢都同意呢去停止竞争。They would have time for other better things. 他们有可能会有时间呢去做其他的更好的事情，which could further boost growth. 那么这些其他的好的事情呢，有可能会提升呢，更进一步的增长。Yet some types of competition 但是呢，有一些类型的竞争，such as sport, have intrinsic value 有内在的价值啊，intrinsic equals to internal 啊等于内在的，OK。Are worth preserving 啊，那么体育呢是有必要保留的啊。OK，humans may also have nothing better to do 啊，人类也有可能呢就是没有更好的事情去做了啊，只能从事体育了。Interest in chess has grown since IBM's Deep Blue first defeated Garry Kasparov。OK，好，原来我啊这个词汇呢应该是那个俄罗斯的这个名字，或者是欧洲的一个人吧。OK，读的可能不准确啊。Then World Champion 那个时候的这个冠军啊，OK，那么这个对下棋的这个兴趣吧，应该当时应该是国际象棋吧，是吧？那么登场了啊，OK，自从呢 IBM 呢当时有一个人工智能呢叫做深蓝，那么第一次呢打败了 Garry 这个人，OK，当时的世界的这个冠军啊，那其实不算什么啊，因为那个国际象棋呢没有围棋这么复杂，那个对吧？那么前几年的这个谷歌的 AlphaGo 击败了所有的这个世界冠军是吧？非常容易的击败了所有的世界冠军啊！所以说，那么现在呢，你跟 AI 去比那个任何的棋类根本就不是对手啊，不沾边儿是吧？OK，没有任何能力去跟那个 AI 去竞争。OK，An entire industry has emerged around esports。好，一个整个的行业呢，就是围绕着这个 esports，就是。电子竞技呢，就是出现了，是吧？Where computers can comfortably defeat humans，那么在这个领域里边呢，电脑呢可以轻松的、愉快的击败了人类啊。OK，their revenues are expected to grow at 20% annual rate over the next decade。OK，他们的收入的话呢，被预期呢是增长20%啊，每一年。OK，在下一个10年都会有这样一个增长速率，会达到。Reaching nearly $11 billion by 2033啊， 到2032年呢，能够达到这个110亿美金，OK，很大的一个市场。Several groups in society today give us a sense of how future humans might spend their time。在社会里的一些群体啊，几个群体的人吧，那么可以给我们一个未来的这个感觉啊，人类有可能会做什么？比如说，aristocrat 是那个一些贵族啊，有钱人、贵族，and bohemians 是那个一些艺术家吧，不合习俗的人啊，OK，enjoying the arts，他们喜欢艺术，Monastics 一些僧侣live within themselves，他们是那个活在自己的世界里边Athletes spend their lives on sports，OK，、okay? 当然运动员的话呢是花时间呢从事运动，OK，the retired dabble in all those pursuits，看来呢国外的这个退休的老人也是一样的是吧？他们是什么都有涉猎什么都有涉猎，OK，that's、okay? pretty good，OK，、okay? 好，我们看下一段下一部分，OK，next、okay? part。
Won't tasks such as parenting remain the refuge of humans? Mr. Bostrom is not so sure. He argues that beyond the post-scarcity world lies a post-instrumental one, in which AIs would become superhuman at childcare too. Keynes himself wrote that there is no country and no people, I think, who can look forward to the age of leisure and of abundance without a dread. For we have been trained too long to strive and not to enjoy. To judge from the behavior and the achievements of the wealthy classes today in any quarter of the world, the outlook is very depressing. The Bible puts it more succinctly: idle hands are the devil's workshop.
Okay. Won't tasks such as parenting remain the refuge of humans? Okay. 像就是父母照顾孩子这样的任务啊，难道不是人类最后的一个避难所吗？Okay. 他的意思就是人类是不是还会保留一些这个基本的一些功能是吧？比如说当父母的功能，OK，当然当父母呢也不能叫基本的这个功能应该是那个一个比较艰巨的复杂的任务是吧？Mr. Bostrom is not so sure，OK，他并不确定He argued that beyond the post-scarcity world lies a post-instrumental one，OK，他说呢那个除了这个叫后稀缺的这个世界呢，那么也存在着一个叫后工具的这个时代我先这么翻译啊，那么我先这么翻译啊，OK，我们看他的解释就是我们就通过上下文呢才知道真实的意思，OK，in which AIs would become superhuman at childcare，OK，那么这指的是呢，就是那个 AI 呢会变成一个超级人类是吧？在照顾孩子方面，OK。Keynes himself wrote that 他也写到了说，there is no country and people，OK，没有国家和没有人。I think who can look forward to the age of leisure and of abundance without a dread，能够去展望就是未来呢，娱乐和这个物质极大丰富的时代呢，就是without a dread 没有是不害怕的，就是说明我们人类的话呢，在展望未来这个物质极大丰富娱乐的这个时代的话呢，都是有这个害怕恐惧的情绪的。为什么呢？For we have been trained too long to strive and not to enjoy。我们已经被训练成什么样了呢？太长时间了，训练是吧？去追求，去奋斗，然后呢，不去享乐是吧？好，这个地方可以 argue 呢。那什么是享乐什么是那个奋斗是吧？如果你认同那个，如果是幸福的话呢，enjoy 是一种成就感的话呢，那你自然的就会喜欢奋斗，是吧？那如果你觉得可以随心所欲的玩无所事事当然这个地方呢就是体现了我自己的价值观吧不太好，是吧？如果你觉得就是每天打游戏或者每天那个玩就是一个好的一个状态，那也是另外的一种选择吧。OK，to judge from the behavior and the achievements of the wealthy classes today。In any quarter of the world, okay. 好，那么来判断呢，就判断这个行为是吧？还有一些这个，一些成就是吧？谁的成就呢？是 of the wealthy classes today，就是富裕阶层他们的这些成就还有行为来判断，在世界的任何的部分吧，quarter 是吧？那么这个 前景啊，这个展望是非常的令人绝望的。当然，这个他展现了自己的价值观吧，就是令人那个 depressing，令人抑郁的原因是，因为富人或者是一些富裕阶层，他们肯定是努力的呀，他们的孩子也会努力的，要不然他们怎么能保持富裕呢？是吧？那个这个有什么 depressing 的啊？当然，这是我和这个作者的价值观不一样的地方。The Bible puts it more succinctly 那么 Bible 呢写得更加简短，OK。Idle hands are the devil's workshop. OK，那么懒惰的话呢是魔鬼的作坊啊。那么我认为呢这句话说得好啊，我认为这句话说得好。OK，that's very good. Idle hands are the devil's workshop. OK，好，最后一部分。
These dynamics suggest a paradox of progress. Although most humans want a better world, if tech becomes too advanced, they may lose purpose. Mr. Bostrom argues that most people would still enjoy activities that have intrinsic value, such as eating tasty food. Utopians believing life had become too easy might decide to challenge themselves, perhaps by colonizing a new planet to try to re-engineer civilization from scratch. At some point, however, even such adventures might cease to feel worthwhile. It is an open question how long humans would be happy hopping between passions, as Pia does in Permutation City. Economists have long believed that humans have unlimited wants and desires, suggesting there are endless variations on things people would like to consume. With the arrival of an AI utopia, this would be put to the test. Quite a lot would ride on the result.
These dynamics suggest a paradox of progress. 这些动态的这些情况啊，动态呢，它说明了一个叫进步的悖论啊，paradox 是悖论是吧？OK，although most humans want a better world，尽管大多数的人类呢都想要一个更好的世界，if tech becomes too advanced，如果科技变得太超前，they may lose purpose，他们会丧失这个目标感。就和我刚才我说的一个超级的富豪吧，一位歹佬一位大佬是吧？他突然有了几个亿之后呢，第一反应呢不是应该有狂喜吧？那个我不知道，因为我不是大佬是吧？那么他就丧失了这个动力嘛，甚至变得抑郁是吧？OK，当然后边调整过来了啊。OK，Mr. Bostrom argues that most people would still enjoy activities that have intrinsic value 啊，他那个。讨论说呢，哈，大多数的人会还是去享受一些活动嘛，从事一些他们喜欢的活动。那些活动的话呢，是有这个内在价值的活动，比如说吃好吃的啊，OK，eating tasty food，OK，utopians 啊，一些那个乌托邦的人，believing life had become too easy 啊，相信呢生活变得太简单了，OK，might decide to challenge themselves，有可能去挑战自我，perhaps by colonizing a new planet。To try to re-engineer civilization from scratch，有可能呢去通过殖民一个新的星球，来去尝试的话呢，再塑重造文明，再建文明是吧？从零开始，from scratch。At some point，however，在一些点上吧，但是啊，even such adventures might cease to feel worthwhile，甚至这样的这些冒险的话呢，有可能会停止呢，让人感觉是有价值的。Okay, 那就太无聊了，是吧？OK，好吧，那个时代，我们先接着看吧。It is an open question，是一个开放式的问题。How long humans would be happy hopping between passions, as Pierre does in Permutation City？OK，、okay, 那么，究竟人类呢，能够多久呢？会乐观的、快乐的去在他们的这个兴趣爱好啊，就他们的热情啊，有热情的这个领域里边。跳来跳去啊，OK，hopping 是跳来跳去，是转换嘛，就像那个在《置换城市》里边那本小说里边那个人物叫 Pierre 一样啊，as Pierre does in Permutation City，economists have long believed that humans have unlimited wants and desires，OK，、okay? 经济学家呢，他long believed 啊，那么很久呢，他们一直相信什么呢？人类都有一个叫无限的一个想法和欲望啊，OK。人类的这个 want，人类的需求和欲望，OK。 suggesting there are endless variations on things people would like to consume 啊。那么他们说呢，有这个永无止境的一个变化啊，对于这个事情的这个变化，就是人们愿意去消费的这个事情，人们愿意去从事的事情，是这个变化的话呢，是永无止境的。With the arrival of the Nanai Utopia and AI Utopia，随着一个人工智能的乌托邦的一个来临啊，this would be put to the end to the test。OK，this would be put to the test。那么这个理念呢，会被啊会经历这个测试的。OK，quite a lot would write down the result。OK，那么有很多的话呢，会被这个结果呢所影响啊。OK，好，write down something 啊。Or somebody 啊，它是一个短语动词 phrasal verb。When something important, such as your reputation or money 啊，就是一些重要的事情，比如说你的声誉和金钱，rise on a particular person or thing。那么它是啊，rise on 一个特定的一个人或者是一个事物啊。It will be gained or achieved if that person or thing is successful。如果那个事物呢和人是成功的，那么你所追求的这个东西啊。你的那个重要的事物呢，也是会达成的。OK，好，所以说的话呢，这个地方是这么翻译的啊。OK，好，我们把听力的话呢再听一遍。
Positional goods, which boost the status of their owners, are also still likely to exist and are, by their nature, scarce. Even if AI surpass humans in art, intellect, music, and sport, humans will probably continue to derive value from surpassing their fellow humans, for example, by having tickets to the hottest events. In 1977, Fred Hirsch, an economist, argued in The Social Limits to Growth, that as wealth increases, a greater fraction of human desire consists of positional goods. Time spent competing goes up, the price of such goods increases, and so their share of GDP rises. The pattern may continue in an AI utopia. Mr. Bostrom notes some types of competition are a failure of coordination. If everyone agrees to stop competing, they would have time for other better things, which could further boost growth. Yet some types of competition, such as sport, have intrinsic value and are worth preserving. Humans may also have nothing better to do. Interest in chess has grown since IBM's Deep Blue first defeated Garry Kasparov, then world champion, in 1997. An entire industry has emerged around e-sports, where computers can comfortably defeat humans. Their revenues are expected to grow at a 20% annual rate over the next decade, reaching nearly $11 billion by 2032. Several groups in society today give us a sense of how future humans might spend their time. Aristocrats and bohemians enjoy the arts. Monastics live within themselves. Athletes spend their lives on sport. The retired dabble in all these pursuits. Won't tasks such as parenting remain the refuge of humans? Mr. Bostrom is not so sure. He argues that beyond the post-scarcity world lies a post-instrumental one, in which AIs would become superhuman at childcare too. Keynes himself wrote that there is no country and no people, I think, who can look forward to the age of leisure and of abundance without a dread, for we have been trained too long to strive and not to enjoy. To judge from the behavior and the achievements of the wealthy classes today in any quarter of the world, the outlook is very depressing. The Bible puts it more succinctly: idle hands are the devil's workshop. These dynamics suggest a paradox of progress. Although most humans want a better world, if tech becomes too advanced, they may lose purpose. Mr. Bostrom argues that most people would still enjoy activities that have intrinsic value, such as eating tasty food. Utopians believing life had become too easy might decide to challenge themselves, perhaps by colonizing a new planet to try to re-engineer civilization from scratch. At some point, however, even such adventures might cease to feel worthwhile. It is an open question how long humans would be happy hopping between passions, as Pia does in Permutation City. Economists have long believed that humans have unlimited wants and desires, suggesting there are endless variations on things people would like to consume. With the arrival of an AI utopia, this would be put to the test. Quite a lot would ride on the result.
Okay, so thanks for watching, guys. I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.